say Black History, you say month. Black History, Black History. If I say Black History, you say month. Black History, Black History. All right, we are Samba Funk, and we are just here to open up the ceremony. We thank you for your time, and we're going to get going on right now. I have, I'm going to pass the mic off to... My contract is fulfilled.
Do you want to hear a little bit more and from now, Samba Funk?
Hello, Supervisor Freed and Supervisor Cohen.
Thank you, Samba Funk, for opening our program tonight. Welcome to the San Francisco Black History Month Expressions Through Music, Art, Dance, and Cuisine, hosted by President of the Board of Supervisors, London Breed, and Supervisor Malia Cohen. We hope you will enjoy the evening that we have planned for you. It is my honor to introduce our host for tonight's Black History Celebration, the first African-American to lead the Board of Supervisors, London Breed, and Supervisor Malia Cohen.
Don't we know how to make an entrance? Hi, everybody. My name is London Breed. I'm president of the Board of Supervisors here in San Francisco. The second African-American to be president of the board, Doris Ward, was the first. She led the way, and here we are today celebrating in this amazing building with each and every one of you. It is truly my honor to serve San Francisco, to do the hard work, but also to have a good time. We know that there are so many things going on all around our country. You all were greeted by protesters tonight, people that we stand in solidarity with what our president is trying to do around gender equality and access to restrooms. It is really sad, it is deplorable, and we have to stand together to fight against any injustice. But tonight, we celebrate. Tomorrow, we fight. Tonight, we have a good time. We enjoy the amazing restaurants, the amazing wine, the amazing people, the amazing network opportunity here for us today. This is about a time to celebrate our history, our culture, who we are, what we represent, and how we in San Francisco, we're still here, and we still matter, and we're going to make sure people know that. And so with that, I want to bring Supervisor, my partner in equality, Supervisor Malia Cohen, to say a few words.
Good evening. Are you guys excited? Man, that Samba Funk ain't no joke. I'm so excited to be here. Do you guys know that this is the fourth annual event? This is incredible. Thank you. This is the fourth annual event, and I'm going to tell you a short story on how this got started. When President Breed, then Supervisor Breed, was elected, she came to me and she said, we need to be doing something for Black History Month. Now, you know there are many events that happen throughout the course of February, and the mayor's office, Mayor Lee in particular, has kicks off the beginning of the month. Well, we thought it was appropriate for us to close it down. Close it down in style. There's a few things that I want to recognize, a few people I want to recognize. The African-American elected leaders that are in the audience today, if you will just stand up and raise your hand. I don't have the full list here. We've got, usually we have the PUC represented with Harlan Kelly, General Manager of the PUC, and Naomi Kelly with the City Administrator's Office. We've got, there she is, the lovely, thank you. I would like to also recognize our colleagues. We've got Supervisor Safai. We've got Supervisor Ronan. We've got Supervisor Norman Yee. Please stand up and be recognized. I also want to take a moment and thank our sponsors. We've got Facebook, AT&T, Uber, Five Point, Noyola, Pacini Group, Trumark Urban, Wells Fargo, Comcast, Recology, and Airbnb. And thank you. And you'll be excited to know who our hosts are in terms of serving food. We've got Radio Africa from District 10. We've got Auntie April's also from District 10. Want to recognize Black Bark Sheba Lounge from District 5. 1300 Fillmore is also representing. We've got Yvonne's Southern Praline Treats from District 10. And also new to our lineup is Mika's Cupcakes and Red Door Catering. So folks, I hope you're excited because we have quite a treat lined up for you. Now, I'd like to bring, which one? Ed Lee up, our wonderful mayor. London said she wanted to bring the mayor up, and I said, which one? As Mayor Lee joins us on the stage here, I want you all to know that as you walked in, you might have noticed that City Hall was lit in red, black, and green. This is thanks to Mayor Lee. A visual reminder of the struggle of the people, of the hope, the promise, and the blood that has been shed. Ladies and gentlemen, please again welcome Mayor Edwin Lee.
Thank you, Supervisor Cohen, Board President London Breed. It's a pleasure to work with you, with the rest of the board. And as they had a chance to present their colleagues, let me present my colleague, former Mayor Willie Brown. He's my colleague. He's advising me. He's keeping me in touch as well. Let me take an opportunity to say thank you for coming to our People's Palace on the close down of Black History Month, and to not just celebrate, but also to be together. We have to be together more often because we got a lot of fights ahead of us, and the only way we're going to win that is to work together. Yes. Together. So I'm going to be politely short tonight, but I do want to say it is not my credit that the wonderful, beautiful lights that are up there, you got to hand it to our city administrator, Naomi Kelly, because she and I know, and certainly Mayor Brown knows, whenever we used to try to change the colors outside, we used to have to send an army of employees to climb out of our windows and to take their gels and to put them on every single light. So we weren't able to do this today because of technology and because Naomi led the effort to celebrate the 100 years of this City Hall and build some resources in to bring technology to this building, to your building. We've improved it, and now today we can have Pan-African colors at the push of a button. So, Naomi, thank you for your leadership. But I want to say, I think she's enjoying herself because at City Hall, we also have other of people from our communities working to make sure we improve lives. You know, you got Derek Brown, who is in Neighborhood Services. And yes, Harlan's at the PUC. Mohammed is at DPW, keeping all of our streets cleaned up. Yeah, I got Paul Henderson helping me figure out all the public safety issues. I got Mawili, who I always say is he. Yeah, well, I got Mawili now. He's Chinese because he's a combination of the Ma's, the Wu's, and the Li's. So that's why I call Mawili. I got him being my liaison to the Board of Supervisors. We have just the talent of our African community helping us run this city. And that's how we say that we're a diverse city. We don't just talk about diversity, we actually perform it. So let me get off the stage, let me see the performances tonight. I know every one of those restaurants except that cupcake. I gotta get one of those cupcakes. So let's get on with the celebrations. Thank you for being the People's Palace. And thank you, London Breed and Malia Khan, for your leadership.
Thank you. All right. Thank you, Mary Lee. Thank you. Bring them up and then we'll go sit down.
Okay, I know you all came to see the performances and not hear a bunch of talking, but we have a special treat for you today. Now, I don't want to blow his head up, but this man has given some of the most incredible speeches at the drop of a dime that I've ever heard in my entire life. I actually called him yesterday and I said, Mr. Mayor, the other mayor, we need you. We need you to come to our program and we need you to inspire the folks who are in attendance. We need to talk about the history and what San Francisco was back in the day for African Americans. We need to know what's going on now and what we're trying to do to make sure our culture is not forgotten. We want you to tell us the story. As the first African American mayor of the city and county of San Francisco, the longest serving speaker of the House, the longest that will ever be, over 15 years as Speaker of the House and over 30 years in the Assembly. This man has been a trailblazer all of his life. He has fought battles that no one thought popular. When the AIDS crisis hit San Francisco, he was at the forefront, protecting folks here in San Francisco, protecting public housing here in San Francisco, dealing with crime. He has been an amazing leader in the political world and an amazing mayor who I am privileged to call a friend. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, please welcome to the stage Mayor Willie Lewis Brown, Jr.
President Breed, Supervisor Cohen, your fellow supervisors who were here and are still here, and of course, my colleague for so many years that I served as mayor of this city, Mayor Lee, we are indeed collectively grateful that you would pause and take note of Black History Month in this nation by having a ceremony here in these great chambers. This building was rehabbed, especially having in mind what this building could be to everybody who wanted to use it, and for whatever purpose. And no purpose can be higher in terms of what this building is used for than ethnic and historical celebrations similar to this celebration which we are engaged in tonight. I came to San Francisco in 1951, August 4th, 1951. And I came after being kicked out of college at Prairie View A&M in Hempstead, Texas. I was protesting the food allegations in the cafeteria. I had no idea that there was no such thing as the right to free speech and to protest at a black school. They packed my things up and sent me home. My mother was flabbergasted and embarrassed to tears. And that was the only way she allowed me to come to San Francisco and live with my uncle. My uncle's reputation was not exactly consistent with what my mother was proud of, and she did not want me to grow up to be like her brother, my uncle. And my goal in life was to be my uncle. When I arrived here, this city was just about to become what we have helped collectively make it. Because you see, when I arrived here, there were no African Americans driving buses and working for Muni. There were no African Americans in police uniforms. There were no African Americans in fire department uniforms. There were no African Americans wearing and being a part of the sheriff's operation. There were no African Americans working in the hotels or on auto roll or doing any of the things that we eventually began to do. For your information on this Black History Month, the very first black toll collector was a college graduate from USF named Burl Toller, who went on to become quite an educator in the city and county of San Francisco. Just those things that I recite to you, you could go to the Asian community and you would find the same limitation on what Asians could do or be a part of in this city. You could go to the Latino community and you'd find it the same way. And there was no such thing as anybody tolerating gays and lesbians. Just was not happening, period. This city was white as you could get it in almost every way. Just think, when you think of the Chinese hospital, Mayor Lee, that hospital came about because Chinese could not and were not being served in the public health facilities, in the private health facilities in this city. Our city was dramatically different. African Americans had moved to this city as part of the people to do something about preparing this nation with resources to fight a war. One of my uncles worked in the Hunters Point Naval Shipyard. One of my uncles lived in the public housing at Westside Courts. You got to understand that even in public housing, there was a limitation on where people of color could live, period. That's just the way this city really was. I reference all of those things because in this year, 2017, we have come a long way. And we've come a long way because we've always been a city in transition, a city extending the opportunity to newcomers to be a part, a full part of every aspect of what this city is all about. Fast forward, when Supervisor Breed, the president of your board, spoke to me a couple of days ago, we thought about how many African Americans had ever served on the Board of Supervisors. 8. Can you imagine? Just think about it. You don't even think about it. You take it for granted because there are 2 now. There's been 2 in the past on some occasions. On some occasions, there's been only 1. Just know that this city requires us to be as diligent as we became over the years, as we went from suing the city for purposes of integrating the fire department, for purposes of making the fire department relevant for women to be firemen. The police department under the same circumstances, and how we had to make the effort to produce the opportunity for people to be promoted. How we had to literally be as militant as it was humanly possible and demonstrate in every way for the opportunity for fair housing. At one time in this city, if you are an African American, there are neighborhoods you could not buy in. The Council for Civic Unity, a collection of African Americans and wonderful militant people committed to the whole business of equal justice under the law in the non-African American community, we do things like phony buyers, so that at the right moment, an African American family would appear to be people working for other people who actually bought the houses. My first engagement with the city and county of San Francisco in the efforts to do something about changing the nature of this city was to go to Forest Knowles, 301 Christopher Drive. We conducted a sit-in demonstration. That's how I met Dianne Feinstein, who was then just a mother and a wife of a man. She marched with me with her kid in a stroller for the purpose of making sure that that group of people building those houses would extend the opportunity to people of color. Yes, on this Black History Day, we've come a long, long ways. The reference the mayor made to the people who work for the city, nothing of that nature was a given. It came about because there were confrontations. It came about because there were demonstrations. It came about because there were lawsuits. It came about because this city was made up of a sufficient number of people who really wanted change to take place, who really wanted diversity to be a reality, who really wanted to extend the opportunity to newcomers. This city is very famous now for every aspect of what I just described. Just think about it. On this Black History Day, when Supervisor Breed talked about the whole business of what happened with reference to the medical needs of some of our people, it was African Americans who stepped up to the plate and got a change in the law of the state of California to do research on AIDS and to do things that needed to be done to provide for that. I smile quite often when I think of it, because it was a vote cast by Merv Dimerly. Merv Dimerly was a black man, Southern California, lieutenant governor, first statewide black elected official. Lieutenant governor can only vote to break a tie in the state senate. On this occasion, the man who made it a tie was a black man, Nate Holden, a senator from Southern California. He caused a tie to come on a bill being carried by George Moscone on behalf of doing something about the issue of what happens with people who were of a different sexual orientation. The Republicans were shocked when the tie occurred. Then Senator Moscone was so good at what he was doing. When Nate Holden cast that vote, he then held all 20 of those votes until Merv Dimerly allegedly returned from Colorado. We had made it appear as if Merv Dimerly was not in the state. And in reality, he was not far away. He showed up and he cast the deciding vote, and it changed the nature of how we treat people who had relationships with each other in private that could no longer be prosecuted. And that spilled over into the time we provided research money for the University of California to deal with the medical problems associated with those relationships. It was black people who put that together. It was black people who executed that. And let me assure you that in that process, it brought about a significant change. We have been changing this nation. San Francisco black folk have been changing this nation. We've been joining with black folk in other parts of the state to do exactly that. Nelson Mandela's freedom came because a black woman named Maxine Waters stepped up and put together the program that caused apartheid to be condemned, and pension funds all over this country followed her leadership on that. And the results were a dramatic change. I cite these examples because on this day, when we reflect upon yesterday and what we have done and how we've done it, you got to know that tomorrow is more demanding, because there is no reason in the world why we should still have to do all the things we have to do to in fact be extended equal opportunity, if at all. Believe me, if you wish a real lesson in how this America has unfolded, and it's equally as applicable in San Francisco, see one movie. It's playing at the Embarcadero, and it's called I Am Not Your Negro. It is a movie at which Samuel L. Jackson is the mod narrator, and in which much of the footage comes from the book. It was written by Jimmy Baldwin, and it carries us through the history of this country in part around the names of three people, the three M's, Martin, Malcolm, and Medgar. It takes their lives and it leads up to their assassination, and it talks about all the things that we collectively have done in pursuit of freedom and equality. It talks about the confrontation over the educational opportunities where separate but equal was what I experienced as a kid graduating from Mineola Colored High. Yes, this is Black History Month. Yes, this is a time and place when we celebrate. But in the process of celebrating, memories must be rekindled, because if we are 10, 15 to 20 years from today, really celebrate, it will be when you can turn the faucet of activities in this nation on, and coming out will be water made up of all of God's children, and we are very much a part of that. Please enjoy your time here tonight. Please enjoy every aspect of this celebration, but just remember, Black Lives Matter.
Thank you, former Mayor Willie Brown. We're going to continue the entertainment portion of our evening. Ryan Nicole is a world-renowned MC and poet whose lyrical prowess has been exploited on the international stage and web platforms, gathering fans in the thousands across the globe. Her musical compositions include a solo mixtape entitled Dissonance and several collaborative efforts with her group New Decades and other artists. Ryan Nicole has performed with a wide array of artists and persons of influence, most notably President Barack Obama. Enough said. She is an actress, most recently joining the African-American Shakespeare Theater. She is an activist. Ryan Nicole has served her community as an organizer and activist for nearly two decades. She is an athlete, but most of all, she is a proud mother and wife. Please welcome Ryan Nicole.
What an honor to be here with you guys this evening. Thank you very much. It's an honor to follow after Mayor Willie Brown. It's a task, one that I am up for the challenge. I came tonight to bring you three words with the intent to encourage: faith, action, and still. We spent the last 8 years
living on a platform of hope and change, and that was aspirational and ideal. Faith and action require movement. They require us to do something a little bit different than just think about what it is that we want in our nation. It requires us to step forward. And still is the acknowledgement of our history, the acknowledgement of who we are, and the recognition that God is still in control, and that we are who He intended us to be, still. You either got the wool over your eyes, the mantle over your heart, the devil over your spirit if you ain't feeling where we are. Where we started is highly debated. Some say it was transatlantic slave ship, hatred. Ain't it a trip? That trip wasn't vacation. Well, we stand, partner. Love it or hate it, front it or fake it. Feel our expression, but you can't stand when we reclaim it. Well, I'm saying, dig my formation, I stay slaying like my man stay laying right. It's how we gonna be all right. We don't die, multiply times 10. Take a deep breath, then we do it again. Man, the way that we rep ain't for you and your friends. Inappropriate appropriation is so hard to defend, so hard to pretend. When you make a trend out of culture, swarming in like a vulture and you strip the movement, moving incongruous to the beat. We already see the things you do, been cool, been peep. Whether you ride or die or kill or cry, baby, we still gonna rise. And then we still gonna pray. We still gonna shine, we still gonna fly, look. And if they shoot us down or take our crown, baby, we still gonna be. We'll be forever us. That means forever God, be forever free. History, way, 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 way back when we waited, waited in the water until the slave catcher catching dog fell up off of our scent. Then even before that, it was the water again. Suffocate the mother tongue way up under the ship so that even our protest to them sound like consent. Even our freedom sound song to them sound like resent. So no matter what we do, we still lose when we win. Well, I ain't playing the games. Ain't even taking no names. I just want mine back. I just want my place and take clarity to think. I just want my space. I want to sit and pray in peace and not feel like prey. I know that I am God. Shouldn't need armed guards, not the KKK marching through our yards, not in 2017. Tell me who's this dream. Tell me where you're from, because I am human being. Whether they ride or die or kill or cry, I came to tell you, we still gonna rise and we still gonna pray. And we still gonna shine, we still gonna fly, look. And if they shoot us down or try to take our crown, listen, we still must be. We'll be forever God. That means forever us, be forever free. Happy Black History Month.
Once again, Miss Ryan Nicole. Now let's celebrate with song. Born the daughter of the late pastor Samuel Williams Sr., Sarah has been singing since the age of 2. Like many other musicians, she got her start in the church, and her roots are grounded in the gospel. Sarah has been fortunate enough to grace the stage with artists such as Dwayne Wiggins, Eric Roberson, Dave Hollister, and Grammy-winning songwriter Gordon Chambers. Sarah also lends her talent in the studio with such esteemed producers as Carl Wheeler and is currently working on her first solo project. Sarah and her band will also perform in the North Light Court tonight. Welcome to the stage, Singing Sarah.
Since it's been a long will come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard to live in, but I'm afraid. Brother, won't you help me, please? Oh, but then he winds up knocking me right back down on my knees. Oh, oh, there are times when I thought
Ladies and gentlemen, Sangin Sarah. Thank you, Sarah. On behalf of Supervisors Breed and Cohen, thank you for joining our celebration tonight. We will wrap up this portion of the evening with dance. Please welcome back to the stage, Samba Funk.
Hello, 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 San Francisco. Happy Black History Month. Here's the test. If I say Black History, you say. If I say Black History, you say. And do you know that Black History Month started as Negro History Week? Thank you very much. And it was started by Carter G. That's right. And we would be remiss if we did not mention Brother Carter G. Woodson on this day. So we wanted to do that and tell you a little bit about our organization. We are Samba Funk, 501c3 nonprofit located at AAACC. Please come see us. We are the Funkquarians, and the Funkquarians represent the babies and the pregnant moms that lost and gave their lives in the Middle Passage. We say 10 million people, but we have to remember that those were mothers and fathers and sisters and brothers and uncles and aunts, not just numbers in a history book. We are the survivors. Our genes are still here, and we give thanks and praise to the ancestors that came before us. So can you say ashe? Can you say ashe? Can you say amen? Now, as my brother DJ said, we are going to go into another level. It's time to take it to another level. So if I could have my Funquarian musicians help me out. Everybody up on your feet. Everybody up on your feet. Put your hands together. Right about now. Everybody's gonna go to the next room. Hey. Summer funk, summer funk. Hey. We're just gonna follow the musicians out. Let's go to the next room. Keep it going. Here we go. Let's go. Francisco, we love you. Happy Black History Month, and we will see you at the reception.